screen. The e-cig TV on the other one. Press record and broadcast. Hello, welcome to e-cig TV. I'm here tonight. We're going to do some RBAs. We're here with Dino, the master of disaster, the Bronx bomber, Brooklyn something or other, and all that good stuff. We have the dapper rapper Dino Striper Swiper Lava Tank. How's that for a name?
That's horrible.
What's going on, brother?
Not much, buddy. How you doing?
Listen, you caught me. I'm trying to type over here on the side. She puts me right on live and then snaps her fingers at me.
I don't see the...
Like I just woke up out of a bad dream. So at any rate, we got a lot of stuff to go over tonight. Dino's going to build a RBA. It's... what is it, Dino?
It's called the Kayfun Mini.
Kayfun Mini.
There's a bunch of... a bunch of different ones that this company, Svovesno, makes. And I think this is a lot of people are gonna like this because they can use this build on any of those products that they have. So
cool.
But I don't.
How
see
do you say
the,
that name?
Svomesto.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Svomesto. It's spelled funny. I think you got to be from another country to really pronounce that right.
Where is the video? I don't see it up.
Gotta press play, bud. What do you want, a channel, you mean?
Yeah, I don't see it.
Gotta press
play. Everybody,
play.
Can everybody see us?
I think so. Yeah, everybody's saying, can everyone hear?
And they say, yeah, I guess they can see us. I don't know why I can't. All right, whatever.
Did you press play on the bottom of it?
I don't see play anywhere, but it's okay. I'll have to live with
it. It's at the bottom of the square. There's a little button.
Yeah, all right, don't worry about it.
Yeah, that confuses you when you look at yourself anyway.
No, you know what it is? I like to look at it so I can see if my camera's in the right place. But it's okay. I'll live without it. Anyway.
All right, you'll get used to it.
No problem.
So, yeah, that's Svovesno. That's what? That's a Russian company, right?
Russian company. The stuff is made in Germany. I've been using it now for a little while, and the stuff is really nice. It's well made, and I probably built it 50 times before I finally got it right. And I'm sure I'm not the only one out there with this with that problem. So.
Yeah, the one that I saw, dude, to tell you the truth, I remember when they came out with, you know, that's back when, like, the only mod of that type was, like, the GG. And I remember looking at a cross-sectional diagram of that thing. That thing had, it looked like it had 1,000 parts to it. I'm sure it didn't. But the way they had it laid out.
It's got a bunch of parts.
Right. So, yeah, so when I saw it on air, I said, wow. And listen, even the first one, it was a sharp-looking mod, really, really sharp. So,
yeah, it's, but anyway, it's
I got
a
bunch
mod.
Of
it
stuff.
Really works well.
I got a bunch of stuff this week from my different sources, mainly Dino. I almost blew my thing up earlier. Almost burnt my RBA up. But I got this little puppy. I'm not even sure what the name it is. It's the IQ100.
No, that's by... the serial number is 100.
Oh.
It's called the IQ.
And what's it by who?
The guy's name is Ilias. He's, I think it's a Romanian guy.
Yeah, Romanian. This puppy kicks. Dino sent it to me all set up. You can't see that vapor because I'm on green screen, but kind of like blows it out. But I got 24 milligram in there, man. If I take more than three hits off it, I get dizzy and fall off my chair. Maybe I'll do it at the end of the thing. It'll be fun to watch. Just gonna have something to talk about.
Yeah, you better lower your nick level if you're gonna be using that thing.
Yeah, bro. I'll tell you what, it's good though. You know what? I keep it. I had it on the table earlier. I took like three hits off it real quick. I was good for like an hour. It's good. Like when I went in the house, took a shower. I was like buzzing the whole time.
Uh-huh.
But you're right though. It's what it is. And I think it's not just this one. I think it's most RBAs. You vaporize all of the nicotine. So if you're used to using 24 milligram in a regular cartonizer or atomizer, and then you use one of these puppies, you vaporize all of it. So you might be using 24, but you know, on a good day, you're vaporizing maybe 16, 18 mils, if even that. But when you put these on there, it vaporizes every bit of that liquid. So
yeah, when I started using Genesis mods, I was still using 24 milligram juice. And then after a while, I found myself, I was driving the car and I started to get dizzy. And then I realized that I had to start lowering my nic level. I'm down to 12 now. So, but it beats the hell out of you.
Right. All right, so I got that. I got a number 014. What's the name of this one?
That's the elevator.
The elevator. This is nice. I like this. This is a solid feeling. It's a DNA 20 tube mod. Telescopic. The adjustment on the button, it's a little bit funky. You got to push it like from side to side, and it's like a little rubber joystick under there. So you like got to dig your nail in to get it. However, for the most part, when I'm using any of the DNA devices, I keep them, at a general setting. So you know, I might have it at 9 watts, 10 watts, depending on what I got on there, but I don't really change it much until I change the atomizer. And you know, it's like the Opus D, you don't really, when they first made them, they made the knobs really easy to turn. You don't want it that easy, because if you do stick it in your pocket or whatever, you don't want it to change so easy that every time you rub your finger past the button, it's going up and down. That was one of the things with the Darwin, to tell you the truth. It spun pretty quick. So you want something it's not super easy to change, but you don't want something that's really hard either. So
that was one of my concerns about that model when they started making it, when I heard it was a joystick, that it was going to be where I was afraid that every time you're going to press the button, that you were going to accidentally advance or decrease the wattage on it. Turned out
right.
it's difficult to change the wattage on it.
Yeah. But, dude, once you realize what you're doing, it's not really that difficult. Like, you can get your finger in there and do it.
At a wattage, I don't change it hardly ever, so it's not an issue for me.
Same here. I also got my hands on a CyBorg, which is pretty cool.
And you must have some good connections getting all these mods.
I do, pal. I got friends all over. This vape's really good, too. I got a prototype cartonizer on here that's it's not performing right. My wife ruined it. I'm trying to burn it out, trying to get the carbon off of the coil. She ran this real heavy coffee liquid on it for a month. So I'm trying to bring it back to life. It's not doing that good. No reflection on the device. I can put it on another DNA 20, but yeah, this is pretty nice. It's really light, the CyBorg. I thought it was going to be fatter. I thought it was going to be heavier from the pictures I saw. It's really not. I don't know how well you can see it. Actually, you compare it to the other Greek one. The Greek one's a little bit shorter. But the Greek one doesn't have all the modular capabilities that this one has, I don't think. The thing I like about this, the end cap, somebody was saying it was aluminum, and they said, people are going to strip it out. But the reality of it is, if it's good aluminum and you're careful screwing stuff on there, you're not going to screw stuff up. But I don't know if you can see this, the whole tip is modular. So if they want to come out with a stainless tip down the road, they can do that. Also,
yeah, he's already talking about coming out with different, like a flat top cap.
Right. Well, when it's modular, I guess you can do that easily.
Yeah, sure.
There might even be some stuff that fits on here now. Like if you had certain hybrid atomizers, you might be able to throw them directly on there without doing
the threading on that mod is the same as the EVIC.
Right.
So you can use the EVIC tubes
right
on that mod also if you want to use EVIC. Because they got some pretty cool EVIC tubes that people are making aftermarket now. And you can use those also.
Well, that's smart. I think that's good design. You know what I mean? It's a thing. And again, like I said, it looks like it's a heavy device, but it's really not. It's all aluminum. It's super light. I thought it was going to be way heavier.
Yeah, the brass one's a lot heavier than that.
Yeah. Oh, they have a brass one.
Yeah, he's got a full brass one.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Again, I'm not a big fan of unfinished aluminum, but it's polished aluminum. If you want that look, if you want a shiny look, and it's not really super shiny. I mean, it's nicely polished. And it's not a super,
size?
What?
Is that the 350 size?
No, this is the, I actually have an 18650 in here. I do have a tube to shrink it down to a 500.
Yeah, it'll go from 18650 to 500 to 350. But the 350,
this is the thing, you know, listen,
lasted me an hour and a half, so.
I'm glad you asked. The thing about using a DNA 20 with an 18350 mod, first of all, you need a high quality IMR battery. And even if it is high quality, you're not going to be able to push out. You know, if you're running at 8 or 9 watts, no problem. You'd fly around a room with it. You know, but you're going to be changing the battery pretty regularly, even with an 18500.
I had it set to 18 watts with an 18350. It lasted me exactly an hour and a half.
Yeah, I mean, so. You know, again, if you're running it at 7 or 8 watts, or even 9 watts, and you got a high ohm, you know, like a 2, 3 ohm atomizer, that'll be a satisfying vape, and it'll last a decent amount of time. But this is the thing, and listen, I've been working with the DNA since before anybody ever even saw it. And I'm not saying that bragging, I'm just saying we were thinking about stuff to do with it. I consider the tube mod first. It's the easiest one to market. There's a number of reasons why it's, you know, why it's better to use a tube mod. Quick, easy, changeable batteries. I steered away from that because, you know, I was talking to Dino about this earlier. First of all, it's like, you know, running a 0.19, you know, I was at a shop last week, the guy was using a 0.19 ohm coil. I'll tell you what, bro, that thing was badass. He had an octopus, you know, things that I think a couple places were selling. I think I was even selling them for a while, but Mad Vapes had them for sure. Just a cheap little RBA that had a big long wick on it. You could drip a bunch in there. And, you know, cheap little thing. But he had a hole drilled in it. He was lung hitting it with a 0.19 ohm thing on it. I'm telling you what, man, that thing was, he was filling the room up. He took three hits, and the other guy in the room got up and opened the door. He said, don't cloud the whole room up like that. He was blowing massive clouds. He was blowing them Dino hits, you know? Like all over the place, right? But it was super airy. He was lung hitting it too. I tried it. It was a great hit. Now, he had an 18350 battery in there. To take that and put that on a DNA 20 or any kind of variable voltage, really, it's like putting 40-inch tires on a Cadillac. You know, it's unnecessary. You don't need a DNA 20 to run a well-wrapped RBA. You know, you can do it with an 18350 battery and a little tube mod. I mean, Dino's got some of them mods, they look like, you know, you could fit them in the palm of your hand, and he blows clouds of smoke out of it, you know? So, I mean, I just don't know. Now, listen. Oh, there he is. He's got it up on the screen. You know, I like some of the RBAs. To tell you the truth, I'm not a big fan because I'm not that great at spinning them up myself. But, you know, he makes some of them really rock. So, honestly, I used a couple of them on the DNA 20 more just to see if it worked. And they work good. It's nice to be able to know exactly what you're doing and control the exact voltage that you're putting to it. But once you get down into the sub-ohms, it's not really that accurate. You know, when they heat up, if it's 0.09, you hold that button down for 10 seconds, it's 0.06, and then the ohm reading starts flashing on the DNA 20. So, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it's a fabulous board, it's a fabulous device, but its real design is to be able to get unlimited performance out of a normal atomizer or cartomizer, and being able to fine tune how you want it to taste, the flavor, and everything else. It's not really that necessary with an RBA. Now, if it's somebody that's not very proficient at building them, like myself, it's great to have something like that so you can turn it up and make it jump through hoops. But, you know, I don't know. It's when you can do the same thing with a little battery, it just doesn't make sense to me to, you know, get too fancy. But at any rate, the CyBorg will go down to a smaller battery, and I'm not saying there's probably, I don't know, three or four tube DNAs out there now. Do you know something like that?
There's the Wizard Evolved is coming out in a couple of weeks, and those two that I know, I don't think there's no more that I know of yet.
Right, so, you know, and I'm not saying anything bad about them. I'm just saying that when you're using a single battery, whether it's an 18350, an 18500, or an 18650, when you start turning them up, you're not going to get a great, you know, fantastic battery life, because it's going to be drawing some major amps out of there, and, you know, I think things are going to get hot. I personally prefer having dual batteries, but that's just me, you know. And again, in all fairness, I haven't used this long. I just got this today. I think the battery will probably hold up similarly. I think the J-Box, he had a single 18650 battery in it, and the people that were using it at 8, 9, 10 watts were saying that it was pretty good. That was the DNA 12. And this board is way more efficient than the first kick in the DNA 12. So it's got a different circuit architecture in there that makes it a lot more efficient when it's pumping out the amps. So, but we'll see. So listen, I've been running my mouth just about long enough. You ready to get started there, Sausage yep. Fingers?
Yep. I'm going to build, this is the Kayfun Mini. Now, if you guys got the Kayfun Mini, or the Kayfun Light, or the Kayfun Gamma, they all pretty much got the same insides. So this build could apply to just about any everyone that they make. So I'll show you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do a micro coil, and I'm gonna use organic cotton wick. This is 26 gauge cantal. This is annealed. Turn it the right way. This is already annealed, so you don't have to torch it. And you can use an eighth inch drill bit for this. I have a little piece of 3mm stainless steel that I use. And
you're getting fancy, pal.
Yeah, I'm getting very fancy.
You had a drill bit last time you did.
Yeah, well, you know it is. I found this little piece of steel, so I just cut it. It makes it a lot easier to wrap.
Nice.
So what you want to do is wrap this towards yourself. You want the legs to be on the bottom in a certain direction. So I'm going to do 5 wraps of this.
That's just the regular wire, right? That's not the ribbon.
No, this is round wire.
Okay.
This is round wire. I'm going to actually do it like I always do it. I wrap extra, and then I pull it off to make it tight. And we're going to go 5 wraps with this. And today, I brought my magnifying glass.
Awesome.
So I can see what I'm doing. And I want to count, just so I can count them. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I got 5 wraps here. So now I got this wrapped on the bit. I'm going to pull this off. And then I'm going to grab it with my tweezers. And I'm going to squeeze it together. All right. And then I'm going to torch it.
Press it once.
When that cools, those coils should stay together pretty good. Now here, let's see if you could see it. Getting very fancy because now I got manual focus. Also, where is my okay? Let's see here. Can you guys see that good? All right, now I am going to put this bit back in, and I'm going to make my connections. Now, you want the wire, the screws are obviously turning clockwise, so I'm going to put my wire on the side, on the outside, so when I pull it around, it's going to tighten up. It's going to tighten up the wire. You're not going the opposite direction.
That's a pretty screwdriver.
Oh, this is a winner, this screwdriver. Okay. Now, this side, what I do is I grab the wire with my pliers and I grab the drill bit. We're going to call it a drill bit. And I just pull it so it tightens it up. And I got to loosen that screw. And then I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this around. And then I'm going to tighten this one up. Now, let me just hold this. I'm going to make this nice and tight. Okay. Now all the connections are made. I'm going to pull this out. And then I am going to just take the excess wire off. Okay. Now I'm going to put this back in. Now what you want to do is you can pull this around and orientate this so you get that coil over the air hole, and also make sure that the wick the contacts are not hitting the base. So I'm going to take this off camera for 1 second so I can I'll show you a little bit of it and then I'll pull it off camera. And pretty much what I'm going to do is just kind of get this coil set. I guess I should have shut my phone off, huh?
That light sounds like a mosquito. You can hear it.
You can hear the light?
Yeah.
All right, I'll shut it off in a second.
No, it's okay. I like mosquitoes.
Just bear with me 1 minute. Okay. All right, now we got the coil set. Let's see here. It's centered over the air hole. And if you look at the side.
So on this device, the air hole is through the bottom?
Through the bottom, yeah. It's actually, it comes through the side of the base, but when it comes up, it comes up through the.
Show me your manual focus skills again, because it's pretty blurry.
Hold on. Oh, look at that. How's that? Is that better?
It's better.
And that coil's got to be raised up off the deck a little bit, so it's not going to make contact. See how it's kind of, the coil's like up in the air a little bit?
Yeah.
All right, now. I'm gonna put this on a mod. See if there's a battery in here. Yeah.
Somebody said you should work in China in the chat.
Oh, really?
Birdo.
All right. Now, I'm going to fire this up. Let me show this.
I'll tell you what, you're pretty good at that.
Hold on. I'm going to fire this up, and then I'm going to squeeze those coils like I did the last time on the other video.
Okay.
You let go of the button, and then you squeeze the coil. Fire it. All right, something's hitting here. See how half the coil's lighting up? Hang on a second. I need my light again.
Are you shaving that thing?
Yeah, right.
That's what it sounds like. It sounds like you got a little razor over there.
How's this coming on camera? Is it going? You can see it okay?
I can see it, yeah.
See, I'm firing it, and then when I let go of the button, I grab the coil and I squeeze the coil. And then what I'll do is I'll spin it around. I'll do it again. All right. Let me just check it. Okay. So now what we got, this coil is finished. Now this coil, how's that focus?
Good. Right there.
That coil should last forever. I mean, 26 gauge Canthal, this stuff is really, really thick. Mm-hmm. All right. So now we're going to put the cotton in. This is probably the most important part because this cotton needs to be set up correctly. All right, let's see here. This is what we're using. Okay, organic cotton balls. You can get them in Whole Foods or I got these on eBay actually. Just find a good one here. All right. And what you got to do is you got to find the edge of it because these things, they're just rolled up. So you find the edge. If I could find the edge.
Focus is out now.
Oh, hold on. How's that?
That's better.
You got to find the edge of it. Here we go. And you unroll this.
Now, where do you get that stuff?
I got this on eBay, but you can buy it in Whole Foods.
Looks and like what you Santa's get is beard. And you they get actually start, trim Santa's beard for that?
Yeah.
That's what it looks like on the camera. That would be organic, right?
All right, here. I'm going to cut the end off here. I'm very wasteful, so just so you know. All right. Then I cut the end. And what I want is a piece about, I guess it's about 3/8 of an inch wide, roughly.
Right.
And that's going to be my wick. All right. Now, getting it in. This actually might be just a tad too wide. Okay. I mean, you could see in relation to the Addy how wide this is. So it's about 3/8 of an inch. So now what I do is I got this whole flat section here. I'm going to take the end, and I kind of wet my fingers, and I make a point out of the end. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to just put it in the coil.
Now, when you're not on camera sometimes, do you just go ahead and lick it, or do you always...
Yeah, I just lick my fingers, or you can just use some water, whatever. All right?
Yeah, because I now, realize you're doing a professional show here and on. You didn't really just lick it right on the camera, but...
Now, watch. When I pull this through, there's some tension, but that coil is not going to move. How's that coming through?
Good.
All right. Now. Okay. Now what I do is I kind of just grab and just peel off, not peeling really, but just any loose stuff I pull off. And I do it on both sides. All right. So now that's what I'm left with. Now here's the part that's important. Because the way this thing wicks, if you jam up the channels too much, it's gonna block the flow. So I don't know if you could see there's like a deck here. This is the top of where the wick is gonna go.
Right.
Let me find something. Hang on a second here. This area right here is where the wick is gonna go. Right. All right. That's the same on all the Kayfuns. So what I do is I take my thumb and I hold it down. And then I take a pair of scissors and I rest it on that bridge or that deck, whatever that lip, you want to call it. And then I just snip it. Now, what you can do is push it down and see how it is. If you got to do a little more, don't be afraid, because this cotton wicks amazingly well. All right. You see how that's like right?
Yep. Yep.
Now I'm going to do the other side, same thing. You hold it down with your thumb. Rest the scissor on that little deck there. And you know, if you got to trim a little bit more, you trim a little bit more. Okay, so here's what you got. You got one piece there. You got one piece there. All right. Now you take the sleeve. Hold on. Take the sleeve. Put the sleeve on. Just nice and easy. And then screw it right on. Now, let's see if you could see in there.
Yeah.
Is that coming through okay?
Yes, it is.
All right, now, here's what I do next. I take some juice. Let me put my focus back to auto. I take some juice. I'm going to drop about, I don't know, maybe 10 drops. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, you could use a toothpick. And what I do is kind of work that wick, pushing it down lightly so that it's sitting in those channels. And pretty much just kind of cleaning it up. Actually, I got to turn on the clippers again so I can see what I'm doing, so I could show you.
Yeah, give it a nice shave, because you don't want Santa's beard hanging out of there.
All right. So that's finished. How's that look? Can you see it?
Oh, it looks like a fresh shave.
All right.
All right, so look. So I'm going to interrupt you. I'm going to talk along while you're going along. Is this a bad time?
No, go ahead.
I want to talk about that cotton.
Right.
Right? Because I'll tell you what. Now, I sort of know the answer, but I'm going to ask you anyway.
Is it going to burn?
When cartonizers were first came out, they had cotton in them. Even I don't know if you were around when they used to do the blue foam and the filter pump, and then they went to silica filling. But when cartonizers first came out, they had cotton in them.
Right.
And they burned. It burned.
Okay, I want to show you something. This is a dripping addy. All right? Yeah. This has got cotton wick in it.
That's right.
This is dual coil, 0.4 ohms. Mm-hmm. You see anything burnt in there?
I do not.
You know why?
Because it's wet.
Because it's wet and it's wick and they keep it wet. The same thing with the Kayfun. If you build it correctly and it wicks properly, it should be soaked with juice enough all the time where it's not going to burn. Obviously, if you get a dry hit, you're burning cotton. All right.
Right.
But if this is built the right way, and you know, people tend to think that if you the more wick you put in, the better it's going to work. It's wrong. There's a fine line between too much and not enough.
Right.
So you got to make sure you want the wick making contact with the bottom of the deck, but you don't want to push it down there where it's going to be clogging up the path of the juice.
Right. Or drown in the air or suffocate in the air or whatever you want to call it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
But this is the thing. And when you were first telling me you were using that, I told you that. The thing is that it won't burn as long as it's wet. You could put a lighter on that when it's wet. And it won't burn at all. But as soon as it starts drying out, it's going to burn. You know, you'll taste it. You know, that's the problem they have with cartomizers. People thought, oh, you know, listen, I've had people call me up and say, this thing don't work. And I'd say, okay, what are you doing? How much liquid did you put in there? And they say, oh, you had to put liquid in it? You know, I don't even know. If you don't give them a clear description, even if you can put a clear description on a website, if they don't read it, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how clear the description is if the people don't read it. But, you know, the bottom line is this. I caution people, if you're using that cotton, make sure it's wet. Cotton, rather.
Yeah, absolutely.
Make sure it's wet. If you start running it dry, it's going to burn. And it ain't going to be a healthy kind of burn. You don't want to be smoking cotton. So the key is to keep that wet all the time. Now, if you're using, that's probably with anything. Even the silica will black it up. It won't burn, but it's not good to be dry vaping it. So.
Well, I'll tell you what. The biggest problem that people have with the Kayfun is that they were saying they couldn't use low resistance coils because it was, you know, they were getting dry hits. And I had the same experience. But when I started using this cotton, yeah, I'm going to show you, look at the resistance on this.
So you're saying the low resistance with silica wick or metal wick was dry?
Well, at least that was my experience. I was getting a lot of dry hits in between. And a lot of friends of mine that I know were also doing, like they said, they had to take dry pulls to get it to prime. So, but this is, I found that 5 wraps on a 3 millimeter, actually it's a 6-5 wrap. It's 6 wraps on the bottom and 5 on the top.
Right.
Of this 26 gauge on a 3 millimeter piece usually comes just under 7 ohms. So here we got, I don't know, can you see that? Is it upside down?
6.9, is it upside? Right?
It's 0.68 ohms.
0.68, yeah.
All right. So this is pretty low.
Right.
All right. Now I'm going to take the top. I'm going to put the chimney on. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put a little more juice in here because you want this thing to be primed pretty good. So you add some juice in there. Put the chimney on. Put the tube on.
You can go back to autofocus again.
It's not focusing?
No, it's a little
blurry. Okay, there we go. All right, and now my tube, top portion. And that's the build. Now, this is a fresh battery. I guess it would help if I put juice in it, right?
Yeah, it'd probably taste better.
Yeah, I primed the wick, but I didn't put juice in. So let me just stick some juice in here.
That looks almost like a VV Nova tube. Mini VV Nova tube on there.
Okay, and she's full. All right.
Nobody here.
How's that? Can you hear that thing sizzling in there?
I can.
Listen to this. I'm telling you, 0.68 ohms on a straight battery, this thing kicks ass.
Now, let me ask
you
something.
And you don't get no dry hits.
The one that you wound for me,
yeah.
How many ohms was that?
That was, I think, 0.78 ohms.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was around 0.7, 0.8 ohms.
That's delicious. That's some good stuff. I'll tell you what, man. I get them, these, and I put the real heavy flavored citruses in there or fruits. They taste fantastic in these things. I never had a juice pop like that. Now, all my juices don't taste fantastic like that. Man. They taste okay, but.
I find certain juices, well, I only vape one juice, so, but I've tried other juices, and I think, and a lot of people also say that some juices taste better with silica, some taste better on a Genesis, you know, I use a mint tasting juice, so, it's pretty good on everything I use. Yeah, check out that mod, though. You want to see something cool? Zoom in on that.
Go ahead, turn it. Oh, that's sweet.
Now, hold
what's
on.
The name of that one?
This is called the My Point.
You're a little out of focus. There you go. You're getting better now. There it is.
How's that?
That's sharp, man.
Where did you is get that upside that down?
I don't know. You see, really, that picture looks the same. So, no, there it is. Where did you
see
that
the skull?
Logo? Yeah,
we made that logo. I build motorcycles, mm-hmm. And that was the logo we made for the bike shop. There you go.
Sure.
And then the bottom, you put the logo on the bottom too. So.
That's sharp. When are you going to ship that to me?
You're never getting this. Nobody's ever getting this.
Just so I can try. I got to try it out. Listen, you can't be showing everybody, you know, how great it is and then don't let me try it.
You could do it. We could do one with an inhaler logo on it if you want.
And they don't really have a cool logo like that. It wouldn't look right. So, yeah. It's good stuff.
Well, I promise the next time.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, I promise the next time I'll build a Genesis, but a lot of people were asking me about the setup for the Kayfun, so I figured I'd do this tonight.
Well, that's good. I'm pretty sure that Kayfun's pretty popular right now, right? A lot of people are getting it.
I hope so. It's a great vape. The beauty part about it is it doesn't leak. I mean, you could stick this in your pocket any position, it won't leak.
How's the demand? You know, the production meeting the demand?
They're not,
yeah.
No. As fast as they make them and put them on the site, as fast as they sell out.
Yeah.
So, they actually got...
Listen, that's pretty much the thing. You know what it is? Go ahead.
Minis are available right now on InTaste. I bought two of them yesterday, and they're still there. So anybody that wants minis, you can get them there right now.
How much are they?
I think 80, something like 87 euros or something like that. It's like 100, yeah. 100 and change.
Euros. Use U.S. dollars. I'm surprised they don't have somebody distributing them in the U.S. yet.
Yeah, no, nobody. Nobody in the U.S. with these yet. And I think Dan's asking where the shipping from. I think it's either shipping from Greece or Germany. I think it's Germany. I'll tell you what, I ordered one of these on like a Friday, and it showed up to my door on a Tuesday. And it came by FedEx.
Really? And that's free shipping, or you got to pay extra?
No, it's like 15 euros. Oh, wait, Vape Rev sells the Kayfuns, but they're out of stock also. So this is the other one they make. If I can reach it here, hang on a second. This is the other one they make. This is the Kayfun Light. This one holds like 4.5 mils of juice. So they make a few different kinds.
You want to shut me out? It's like a try.
Yeah, you got enough stuff today.
I did get a lot of stuff today.
You got a lot of stuff to play around. You all set up too, so you'll have that too soon.
That's cool. I'll tell you what, I got a lot of stuff coming down the pipe. I was on vacation last week, and I'm going again this week. You know, it's crazy, I was telling you earlier, I've been on like 4 vacations in the summer, and I haven't rested at one of them yet. So, the guy that we went with last week, he had another house rented in Virginia Beach, so next week, I'm going down to Virginia Beach. I'm chilling out. I'm turning everything off. But I got a lot of stuff, a lot of irons in the fire. I got these 26500, 26650 mechanical mods supposed to be coming out of the anodizer at the end of the week. And then I have an RBA that's supposed to be finishing up the following week. So I got a lot of stuff going on. It's going to be a busy... You know, listen, we're coming right into the busy time. I got to start ordering in September to get my orders for Christmas so they don't get bound up through China with like all the atomizers and cartomizers and all that stuff. So it's a grind. But yeah, I got plenty of stuff. I told you, this thing here is definitely going on vacation. I'm going to... I was hoping we were going to do it tonight, but I'm going to try and build a lower ohm attic for this one. I almost set this on fire tonight right before the show.
Which one?
I left it sitting on the table on. I think it got better. It was like a fresh burn on it or something. The thing was so hot, I picked it up and it burnt my hand. But, yeah, all that stuff should be ready, so.
Well, you got to try
this. We're going to do a contest. I was going to do it tonight, but I think I'm just going to announce it. What are you doing there, huh?
What? I'm doing
anything. Did I do that?
Yes.
How did I do it?
I don't know. I
didn't do it. Am I still on? Can you still hear me, Dino?
You dropped. Hopefully.
Yeah, I hear you. Fine.
All right, hold on. Nobody can hear me.
I'm calling you.
Can you hear me now? Can anybody hear me? No, I guess it don't matter.
I hear you.
You hear me? Have you been hearing me all along?
You never stopped talking.
You're still on.
You're still on, and they hear you too.
I don't know what happened.
Your call dropped.
Yeah, but I could still hear everything.
Because you're on a room mic.
No, I could hear.
I don't know.
I thought I could hear me. I don't know. I couldn't hear Dino, I guess, when I was off there. It doesn't matter. I just keep talking anyway. But I don't even know where I left off. But at any rate, yeah, I got a lot of stuff coming up. And the contest. I wanted to do it this week, and what I'm going to do is announce it. So I'm going to be giving away one of these new 26650s and an RBA. I might give two of them away. They're going to have, I'm know if you can see this. I got too much stuff here. But they're gonna have a long tube and a short tube. It's gonna be 26,500 and a 26,650. If I got the right one here. No, that ain't it. And they have a
we gotta get a close up camera.
Kick tube. I know. Listen, dude, every time I go to set it up, you gotta see their rig here. Today Skype, last week I got four Skypes, so I run different stuff. You're on one and two. And then I run the music at the beginning on another one and the video on another one. So Skype 4 last week didn't want to start up at the beginning of the show. So we did a show without it. As soon as I turned everything off, stopped recording, I went and turned Skype 4 on and it started right up. You know, they're all separate. There's a separate little computer for each one. Make a long story short, tonight I started up, it don't work. But the other one that hasn't been working is working. So who knows? But I got to get Jamie here and give me a tune-up. Check all the wiring and all that stuff. I think it's just, there's so much stuff going into it that it gets tough to mouth. So at any rate, watch here, watch e-cig TV, watch my thread in ECF. We're going to, by the next show, all the rules and everything like that will be going. Oh, this is the other thing I want to show. I had this here and I forgot it. I got this last week too. I taste 34. Let me tell you something. This thing here, you drop out on your foot, you're going to the hospital.
Why is it only taking 18,650?
You know, because it wouldn't fit all these bars. And, you know, I don't know. Listen, I Googled it. You know, if you Google it, I think it's the IM-34 machine gun. It looks just like this. It's one of the most popular machine guns ever made. It's like a Gatling gun machine gun. They mount them on tanks, boats. They got one that you can carry, like, down by your hip. It's a bad mamma jamma, dude. And this looks just like it. Why they made it? Listen, it's definitely a novelty. You know, you walk in somewhere with that thing, and people are going to look at you like you're out of your mind. I don't care where you're at. Well, maybe not, like, you know, a vape me. But I went to a shop down in South Jersey that I do a little business with here and there when I was on vacation because I was close. And they had a couple of them in there. And the guy was nice enough to let me have one. So... it's pretty cool. Listen, it works. It goes to 12.5 watts. It does what it says it's going to do. It's enormous. It takes an 18650 battery. The thing looks like it'd fit a 3500 battery in it, but it don't. The tube inside's like really skinny. The one I have, I'm not sure it's the final one because I've seen a couple videos on it where they said the first one, the battery was shaking around in it. The second one wasn't. This battery shakes around a little bit inside it. If you go like that, you can hear it rattling. The connector on it works great. It's got a nice trim ring that comes off at the end of there. From what I understand, it's going to be pretty expensive. I haven't seen anybody actually selling them yet. I think the suggested retail is like $169 or $179. For guys that want something different like me, and you just want to own one of everything, you got to get one. You know, how much, it's probably never, the case is really cool. I actually want to take the thing out of there and use the case for something else, but it's that nice. But, yeah, I don't know how much I'm actually going to use it. I don't think many. But, yeah, so that's about it. That's around. There's Rob's in there. Rob's in there messing with you, dude. He's in the chat. Rob, listen, I got a bone to pick with you. One of these days, pal, I'm going to get down there. I had an appointment to come down there, or plans to come down there twice with Dino already and couldn't get there. But I still got to get that, I busted a ProVary putting it in that 26652 mod. I got impatient with it. It wasn't your fault, but I bought a new one and I got to bring it all down there. I was going to ship it to Dino and have him do it. But I'm one of them immediate gratification guys. I want to drive down there and, or up there and get it fixed and walk out of there with it pumping. So, it's a cool mod. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, I don't know if they even still sell it, but you had a, it's a 26650 kit that you can take a ProVary, you got to do the V2, which I found out, the V1 definitely doesn't work. You get the V2 ProVary and it slides into the tube and, you know, makes it a 26650 ProVary. It's really sharp looking too. Hold on a second.
Now we can talk about Drew while he's gone.
What?
Because he can't hear us. So if you got something to say, say it now.
Short break for a word from our non-sponsor. Here it is right here. Got it sitting right over there. I keep reminding myself to get it done, but I don't know if you can picture it. Oh, shit. I don't know if everybody else did. Every time I don't touch the screen, it goes into an advertisement on that. Justin TV. But at any rate, here it is. That's it. I don't know how well you can see it. That's the button side. That's the screen side. What are you doing?
Put it up the camera. You just give me it.
Come on. Say hello.
Come on, Drew.
Say hello.
Hi.
Say hi, everybody. Okay, that's my wife. She's like camera shy. So, all right, back it up, son. Back it up. I'll back it up, baby. A little bit more. Look. Oh, there you go. No, you're too high. A little bit. Oh, down a little bit. Oh, no. Come on. How are you? Look over there. Look.
I'm saying, okay.
Back it up. Back it up, baby. Come on. Come on over to daddy. A little closer. Oh, there you go. There you go, mama. Spin it. Spin it good. Yeah, so at any rate, that's the thing that Rob from Flow of Vapor sells. He's the same guy who's doing the, what I showed you earlier, the, thank you, honey.
Mm-hmm.
The CyBorg mod. So, but I don't even know, Rob, are you still selling that thing, or did you, the ProVary kit thing? I can't see. It's like a lag. Yeah, well, when I got it from him at a meet in, where the hell was I? At a meet in New York at a diner. It was a local meet there, and I got it, and it was, I think it was $85. Came with the whole kit, and then you just needed to get the, it was $75 or $80 or something like that for the thing. And I had a ProVary, but I had the new one, or the old one. So it needed the V2. So I looked at the, he built one there when we were there. He put one together for Lou from Vape TV. And I said, I looked at his, and I told him there, I said, man, I wish I had one of these here. I tried to buy one off somebody, because I knew I was going to mess it up. But, I looked at it, and when I got it home, I said, man, this thing looks exactly the same. He's just saying you need a V2 or whatever. They don't, V1, V2 or whatever. So I got it in there. I did exactly the way he showed me. It was too tight. The board was too fat. And when I tapped it in, it like splintered the edge of the board a little bit. And then I had to get it out, and I got impatient with it, and I just ripped it in half with a pair of needle-nose pliers and threw it on the floor. So I ordered a V2. I got one over there, and I figured next time I go to a show, but it's been a while, so...
Shop. He's his brick and mortar. I gotta tell you, he's got some setup over there. It's
yeah,
weird.
I heard.
Yeah, it's got big screen television. He's got like a bar there. I mean, it's nice, really nice.
Well, listen, you know, I got a TV in my house. I'm not gonna drive to New York to see his TV, but I hear he's got some really trick ass mods over there too.
It's sweet. It's a nice place.
Cool stuff. That's what I would go for. I'm just saying. I'm not being wise. I'm just saying. If I'm driving all the way there, It's for the mods he's selling.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nobody wants to see that.
And of course, to spend, you know, quality time with you,
your friends.
All right, listen, so it's 9 o'clock, man. I want to thank everybody for coming in. Again, keep your eyes peeled. Let's give something away. Mm-hmm. What do you want to do? Make up a contest, you know?
Bullshit. Don't do this to me again. You do this to me every friggin' week.
Hon, what do you got? What do you think?
I don't know. You want to do the number of wraps?
Yeah, we're going to do the number of wraps
for the Kayfun RBA.
On a Kayfun RBA that he did tonight. And I'm going to give away...
There it goes. Tim.
Vegas and Dan. All right, look. Vegas and Dan won. So send me an email. I'm going to surprise you. Oh, look. Everybody's guessing. Mm-hmm. 5-6. Susan Erie was right, too. It was a 5-6, but the final was a 5. At least that's what he said. Mudflaps right on cue as usual. He said, oh, 01 wraps. That's the .01 Addy. Okay, so, hey, there's John Vesey. What's going on? Blah, blah. Yeah, send me an email. Tim and who did I say?
Dan.
Tim and Dan Patrick. Dan said he's going to pay it forward to flap. Good to see you, John. We're wrapping up. But I want to thank everybody for coming in. Send me an email. You know the drill, hun. Put the email in the box, in the chat. Again, we'll be back in 2 weeks. We're going to do another RBA super duper prototype. He's going to be wrapping a prototype of my RBA that's coming out. And we'll put it on some cool mods and all that good shit. And my wife's working on a contest. So watch this forum. Actually, we'll be posting in this chat. So if you check in here and click in this chat or watch the forum in ECF, Facebook, Twitter, all that good stuff, we're going to be giving away a couple of these 526-650 mechanical mods, bottom butt mechanical mods.
I'm going to shave for the next show, too.
Oh, man. Dino Shave, what a treat. Make sure you tune in. Don't miss it. All right, everybody. Thanks again for coming in. This is eSig TV, and we're over. Every month.